The book I choose is the book of Walter Mignolo and Catherine Walsh on decoloniality, concept, analytics, and praxis, that it focuses on the re-existence and the decoloniality as a verb. How re-existence is a practice of decoloniality in that sense. And at the beginning of my practice, especially with projects like Stateless Nation and Roadmap and other few projects, it was all the time maybe denouncing the power system and trying to resist against it and trying to understand the matrix of control and respond all the time or feeding into that matrix of control. And in the last period, our last projects like the Tree School, like the Living Room, we are trying to understand if there are ways, rather than resisting, to re-exist, to imagine a different world where we can live by practicing decoloniality, where our alliances becomes different, where our looking at the world and where our knowledge production is taking place from a complete different resources and places. I met Walter Mignolo only two years ago, and we were both thinking, how come we never met before? No, and Walter was saying, my God, you are doing in architecture exactly what I was trying to do in the words. And actually, we are also initiating a group called Tents of Thoughts, where we are thinking how to embrace friendship and way of thinking together as a way of practicing decoloniality. I had experience living both in Italy and Sweden and have been part of marginalized communities and connected to marginalized communities and as a woman architect. And I guess that the public space definitely has been my main challenge. Public space for me is also about building values of society and who has the right to build these values and who has less the right to build these values. Women and marginalized communities and other all sorts of people that are actually excluded by that public space would use their domestic as a means to sort of still be participating in creating parallel different kinds of values. And a lot of time these two places never comes together. And for me to re-exist is to bring these two spaces together. And in that sense, I think that the living room is a very important example in that sense, where I recognize that a lot of marginalized community in places like Sweden has no means and possibilities of being active members in the public space. And they ended up by exercising their life in their living room. And I think that we should never give up with the public, right? As our right to still be transforming society and to still be building different values and to still be demanding that we are living in a pluricultural societies and that the public space needs to be transforming. Sometimes I feel that we have been freezing the public space in one way of narration. And I think that now it's our very important task to move forward. And then, of course, the pandemic definitely will be pushing in that direction because, suddenly the house acquire as a space, as also a place of living, acquire a completely different meaning. In order to re-exist, we have to be able to reconnect.